Hi everyone, how's it going? Hope you had a good day at Sonar. It's an honor to be back here again. I think this is the third year running I've done it, so it's brilliant to be back in Barcelona. Today I'm going to be doing a deconstruction. You may have seen some of these on YouTube, the Point Blank YouTube channel. So I'm the head of curriculum at Point Blank Music School, and we're going to be looking at this track. It seemed very appropriate to do this track because Gorillaz are actually playing tomorrow night. Don't know if any of you are going to go to it, but I'm definitely going to be there. I can't wait. So I think that before we get into it, we should remind ourselves of this fantastic, brilliant track. So let's have a listen to it. I won't play all of it, like the first half or whatever, of Feel Good Inc. by Gorillaz. What a tune, put it together for Feel Good Inc. So, always good to focus on a few fun facts about the tune. I'm not sure if they're that fun, but anyway, produced by Danger Mouse and the Gorillaz. Danger Mouse, famous for the Grey album, where he mixed the a cappella of Jay-Z's Black album with the Beatles' White album. He also went on to produce Niles Barkley, that was one of his projects. The original Gorillaz members, Damon Albarn of Blur and many other projects, and Jamie Hewlett, invented Tank Girl. Vocals by Damon Albarn himself, he normally features on the Gorillaz tracks, but also guesting on this track, De La Soul. You may know them from their groundbreaking album, 3 Feet High and Rising. It's from their second LP, Demon Days. It was the lead single. Came out on May the 9th, 2005, so 13 years old, if I've done my maths correctly, and came out on Parlophone Virgin, recorded at Kong Studios, which I believe is Damon's studio, mixed at the Pierce Rooms. And style-wise, it's kind of a real mishmash of styles. It's kind of alternative rock, funk, hip-hop, a real kind of hybrid, so great. And I think it's quite kind of indicative of the style of quite a typical Gorillaz track, where there's quite a kind of hard section wrapped, and then it kind of goes into a really nice kind of sweet section, more of the kind of Damon Albarn Blur kind of style of writing that he had. A really great track. There aren't any discernible samples on this track, although there is one, this kind of weird Hawaiian guitar sample that I'm not sure if it's a sample or if it was done in the studio. But there is a vocal reference by De La Soul, and it's from this track from 1992 by Luke called I Wanna Rock. So I'll just play you the little snippet and see if you can recognize the vocal reference.
Don't stop, get it.
slightly dubious video, but anyway, that's the vocal reference. So just before we get into it, just quickly a word about what a deconstruction is. So this is basically where we take apart elements of a track to try to fully understand them. And we use this at Point Blank as an educational tool to teach music theory and production techniques. And the first course that I wrote for Point Blank was called EMC, Electronic Music Composition. And this technique was used throughout that to basically put music theory into context with electronic music and just try to kind of make it fun rather than sitting down and just endlessly practicing scales. Although scales do come into it, just trying to contextualize it. And just a word that the module, EMC features in the music composition module, which is on our BA ONS Music Production and Sound Engineering degree. Enough of that. Let's get into the actual deconstruction part of it. So you might recognize this. Anyone recognize this software? It's Ableton Live 10, and I'm using this. I've got a push 2 controller as well. So this is the hardware controller. So I'm going to be mostly kind of putting in the parts using push straight into Ableton Live 10. So I think we should just kick off with the beat. It's always a good place to start. And I've got some sounds here. Got a kick, a snare, a closed hi-hat, slightly more open hi-hat, some clicky rim-shotty sounds there, another clicky hat sound, a crash, and then a clap sound as well. So I'm going to put in, to start with, an 8-bar pattern. I've got quantize, record quantize on, so it's going to be putting in time. And I've got the metronome on as well. So let's put it in. There we go. So I don't think I've made any mistakes. Take the metronome off for the moment. So pretty simple. I'm now going to put in the hi-hat pattern. The little clicky sound. Now for this sound here, it just comes in bar 6, and I'm going to use the repeat function, so it plays just 16th note there. So I'm going to put that in now. There we go. And then finally, there's this clap sound that goes all the way through. I think this was just them clapping along, but I'm going to put that in anyway. So here we go. There we go. So we've got our 8-bar section. Now, there are two views in Ableton. It's what kind of really makes it, it distinguishes it from DAWs like Logic. It's got the traditional linear view, which is called a range view, but it's also got this session view here. And these here are called clips. It's basically like a grid system, so you can actually create loops and then trigger them in any loop at any point. But you've also got the horizontal lines, which are called scenes. And with these, you can actually build up the different sections and essentially build up the arrangement so you can actually play that in live. So I'm going to work on the arrangement now because this track has got two main sections. It's got the kind of verse section where Damon is singing or kind of rapping, and then later on De La Soul rap. And then you've got the sweet kind of strummed guitar section as well. So we're going to build up those different sections. So I'm going to use push for that. It's got a duplicate function. And I'm just going to copy these parts down. So we're going to have six scenes. There's a couple of things I'm going to do, just a bit of housekeeping. This clip here, the fifth scene down, I'm just going to change the loop length to 4 bars, and you'll see why a bit later. And also, for the third scene, I'm just going to make that into a 2-bar loop, a simplified 2-bar loop. So let's put that, I'll put the metronome back on. Put the clap in as well. Okay, and then also for this section here, the fourth scene down, I'm just going to put the clap in. Okay, so we have a full complement of beats. Right, got the beats done. Next thing to look at is the bass. And also, this is a good opportunity to just look at a bit of the music theory behind this track. So I'm going to bring up my virtual keyboard here, which I hope you can see, and also little graphic here, which is showing the scale and the key. So not sure how much you know about basic music theory, but most popular music has got a key signature. And this is it's the kind of foundation, tonal foundation of the track. And it defines the track, and it defines the notes that are played within that song. So for this particular track, it's in E flat minor. It's not the easiest of scale. And I'll play you the notes here. It's got 6 flats, E flat, F, G flat, A flat, B flat, C flat, D flat, E flat. It might be weird that we're calling this note C flat, because that's actually a B. But the thing is we've got a B flat, so we can't have a B flat and a B. We have to have one occurrence of each note within the diatonic scale. So those are the notes. Now, if we look at the bass line, it goes like this. So it's using only the notes from that scale. And actually, those notes, the bass line, are kind of implying a chord sequence. Quick note about chords. So we can define chords by the degrees of the scale. So because this is the root note of E flat minor, we call this the 1 chord. As we go up on the degrees of the scale, 2 chord, 3 chord, 4 chord, 5 chord, 6 chord, 7 chord, and then back to the 1 chord. So what's happening with this bass line, it's going... It's implying an E flat. Then the 5 chord, the B flat minor. So we have a 1-5-4-1. But there are no particular chords on the bass line. So let's put the bass line in. Now, one thing about push that's great is that you can actually define the scale so that you don't play any wrong notes. So you can actually define that the scale is E flat minor on here. And the orange, I don't know if you can see them, but the orange pads, the colored pads, indicate the tonic note. So let's put this in. And I'll leave that there for the moment. There we go. So we've got that in. I'm going to do a similar thing now. So I can build up the arrangement. I'm just going to copy that part down there to the different scenes. And there's one bit here where I put in that 2-bar loop where it actually changes as a little riff. So let's put that in. So we can now go back and listen to the different parts. And I'm just a note, I'm just using push here to trigger the different scenes. So we've got our first section. And the one I just put in. So So hopefully you're getting a sense of how easy it is to actually do the arrangement on the fly, and that's the brilliant thing about Ableton. So let's crack on with putting some parts in. The next part is an electric guitar part, and it's just mirroring that bass line. So let's put that in. There we go. I'm just going to listen through just to make sure I haven't made any mistakes. It appears not. Amazing. So I'm going to duplicate that down as well so I can put it on the different scenes. Okay, now there's another guitar part. Now, unfortunately, I haven't got an electric guitar, and I don't play electric guitar as well, so I'm going for the next best thing, which is something from one of the Ableton packs that it comes with, and electric guitar sound. Let's just bring back the chords. There we go. Now, this is quite a kind of lazy, out-of-tune guitar, and I think it was just probably Damon just jamming along, and then they just took that one section and then looped it up. But what's interesting about it is it's actually playing major chords, even though the track's in a minor key, it's playing... So E-flat major, D-flat major, and C-flat major. So let's put it in. It's kind of like a broken chord, really, a bit like an arpeggio. So let's put that in. And I think that the reason it works is probably because it was a bit out of tune, and I think the G here was probably halfway in between an F sharp and a G, which was to make it not really major or minor. So let's duplicate that part down. There we go, building up a part. So we've got the main kind of verse section. Now let's look at this lovely strummed kind of sweeter section. And for this, again, I haven't got a guitar. I haven't got an acoustic guitar. So I borrowed a contact sound, Native Instruments contact. This is from the strummed acoustic. And what's great about this is it's got a whole load of preset patterns, and you can just basically play the chords like that. Now, it's great, but unfortunately, it didn't have the right rhythm. So I had to sort of be a bit creative with it and actually record those down and then chop them up and put them into a drum rack, which I can play now. Before I do that, though, let's just quickly look at the chords for that, because these are slightly different chords. You should be able to see them here. Strummed guitar and synth. We've got E-flat minor, which is the one chord, D-flat major, which is the seven chord, A-flat minor, which is the four chord, and then B-flat minor, which is the five chord. And that dictates all the parts for that section. So let's go back to this part here. Just going to hide the chords. And I'm going to put it into scene five. And it's going to actually, this bit is 8 bars plus 2 bars at the end. So I'm going to record it as a 10 bar loop and then copy back those parts to the scene before. So let's put that in now. There we go. I'm just going to quickly go back to the drums of this part here, because I thought I made that a 4-bar loop, but I have now. So okay, so moving swiftly on, now we have another part, which is it's a nylon guitar single riff part that goes over that. Again, this is another Ableton sound. So let's put that in now. Great. Okay, so that's in. Right, now we're getting to, for me, which is, for me, the thing that really kind of hooked me into the track, which is this beautiful kind of glissando synth part. So let's have a look at what I've done to recreate this. I've actually used a synth called Silent, purely because I was using it for another track, and I just stumbled across this sound, and I thought, oh, that really sounds like the one, the synth from Feel Good Inc. So the main thing I've done with it is I've just used the macro here to map to the filter cutoff. And you'll see how that's used in a bit. I've also created a rack here to make my life a little bit easier, because it's playing a kind of quite fast arpeggio, which is quite hard to do. So I've actually used the arpeggiator device in Ableton. If I turn that on now, you can see it's kind of doing the job for me. But what to make it even easier, I can use put the chord device before that and actually play the notes of the triad in two octaves. So I put that on, and then what happens is I just play that one note. So that's great. The thing about the chord device is you specify the intervals above. So it's fine for these chords, but when I play the D flat major, it's actually playing a D flat minor. So in order to fix that, I then use the scale device in Ableton, which basically, if ever there's an occurrence of a note that's not in the scale of E flat minor, it shifts it up. So. So hope you followed that, but I'm going to record that in now, and then we'll copy it back to the scene before, and I'll do a bit of filtering. Okay, so the track's coming together. So now I'm going to copy these back to the scene before where there's just the clap, there's not the beat. So I'm going to do that now, copy those back. And I'm going to use the filter macro here so I can filter up that sound. So let's record that in. There we go. So it goes from that to. So we're really getting there now, but there are, let me see, two more sounds we can look at. And I think, again, this is a real sort of distinctive part of the track, and it's this kind of real 80s synth stab, which I love. So let's have a look at that. I've built another rack here. So I'm using this Tal Uno LX. It's a fantastic synth. It's a recreation of the Roland Juno 60. And the key thing about this is the LFO, and it's affecting the pitch. So if I turn it on, and the chord that I'm playing is an E flat minor 9. Pretty crazy. So let's keep that on. I've used the chord device again on this, just so I don't have to play all the notes, being a bit lazy, but it makes life a bit easier, especially on push. So now I just have to hold down the one note. I've added a bit of EQ just to roughen up the sound, and also added some ping pong delay with the great new Live 10 Echo device. Cool. So I'm going to put those. There are three scenes on here where that occurs. So I'm going to put that in now. Here we go. So let's put it in. So that's the first one. The next one is in the sort of chorus section. And that comes right at the end in bar 10. So let's record that in. Great, and finally, in the section where De La Soul come in. So let's record that in. This comes in bar 8. Great, so I just went slightly over there, made that a 9-bar loop. Great, so there's one sound left, and this is this quite strange, kind of almost like dubstep-y sound that comes in the rap section. And I've just used the good old Ableton Live analog device for this. So what makes this distinctive is the filter envelope, and it's actually set to a negative value. If I put it to positive, you get that kind of sound, kind of zappy sound. But putting it back to negative, you get that sort of slightly slower attack with the filter envelope. So let's put that into this section as well. Great, so we've got all the sections in now. Obviously, there are other bits, there are the sort of drum dropouts, but I just wanted to kind of put this into more of a sort of distilled, compact version. Now, I was lucky enough to actually get hold of the a cappella for this, which always is always a nice way to finish off these deconstructions. So I'm going to drag these over to this track here, and we can have a little listen to what the a cappella sounds like soloed, and then we'll play through the track with the vocal and see how it sounds. I'm just copying this over here. Great. So let's just lose that. And first time for some of you, here is the vocal soloed. So all your favorite streets is appealing to see. You won't get undercounted cause you're dead and free. So that's a bit of the verse. It's got that, Damon often uses that kind of telephone effect, that kind of EQing. So kind of really kind of makes his voice sound a bit rougher. Let's listen to the chorus. Windmill, windmill for the land, the forever hand in hand. Dig it all out on your stride. It is taking for all in really beautiful. So let's have a listen through with my deconstructed parts and the a cappella. So here we go, Feel Good Ink, ski version. Thank you.
Yeah, been repping all of this shit. Watch me as I gravitate. Ghost town, it's small town with your sound. You in the blaze, gon' bite the dust, can't fight with us. With your sound, you kill the hate, so don't stop. Get it, until you cheddar head and watch the way I navigate.
There we go. Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for listening.